Hello, my name is Ben Hoffmans and I'm in SAP Product Management for Smart Data Integration. And I will guide you through a demo where I will show you how we can use Smart Data Integration for integrating data from on-premise to a HANA database on the HANA Cloud Platform. In this demo, we'll have a look at Smart Data Integration on the HANA Cloud Platform. So I'm starting from the cockpit on my HANA Cloud Platform. I'll go to the database where I have Smart Data Integration enabled. So here's my database, it's already started. The data provisioning server, so the SDI server, is enabled. And via the regular HANA web-based development workbench, we'll be able to create all the needed objects to move data from an on-premise system into this HANA database on HCP. So I'll go to the workbench. There are two areas that are of importance. First of all, there is the editor, where we create the design time objects, so where we define which data we want to replicate and which transformation step it needs to go through. And then the catalog, where the actual runtime objects are, where also my tables and my remote sources are. We'll start with the catalog, where I first want to have a look here at the remote sources. So with the remote sources, you create a connectivity to your source systems. As an example here, if I would create a new remote source, here you can see all the properties you need to provide. So depending on which adapter you choose, let's say we want to connect to an ABAP system, there is an ABAP adapter, you will see the typical parameters you need to connect to an ABAP-based system. Same for the database, there is also here in the list a SQL Server adapter, the SQL Server log reader. So for that SQL Server adapter, you would find other properties specifically for SQL Server. Also, what I should show is that before you can even go here, of course, you need to have a data provisioning agent. So this is a prerequisite. You need to install somewhere in your on-premise landscape this data provisioning agent. And that data provisioning agent will then take care of connecting to your sources so that it can send the data to the HANA database in the cloud. And you can see here, this data provisioning agent is connected to my trial account where my HANA database is. And there are a few adapters enabled, like the ABAP adapter that we just saw in the remote source. There are more here. I see an Excel adapter, a HANA adapter, and also here the other one I showed, the SQL Server log reader adapter. Okay, so this agent is configured on-premise, is running there, and here from my remote source, I'm able to use it. And so first thing we can do, let's have a look at that ABAP adapter again, is we can see all the metadata from that system. I could navigate it here through the structures, go to the extractors, go to the applications. But what's even better is just to use a search capability so that you don't need to navigate. I can go to Find Table. And then basically here, select, I want to see all my tables that start with, let's say, KNA1, which should give all my tables that contain customer master data. So there we go. Here are my tables. There are a few of them, but it's this one I need, my KNA1 table with my customer master. And so from here, I can create a virtual table. I just need to give it a name. Let's call it, let's erase everything here. Demo customer, ABAP. And I want to store it in my own schema. I have a schema, SDI_demo. By clicking OK, the virtual table will be created. And this virtual table is now here visible in my schema. I will need to refresh, and here is my demo customers ABAP. The green icon here in front, the green pie basically, means that this is a virtual table, so the data is not stored in HANA, it's stored in a remote system, an ABAP system. But from here, I can already do a select star on that table, and it will retrieve the data from the on-premise system and visualize it here in HANA. And you can use it in your queries to do joins and so on with existing data. But the data still resides on the on-premise system. As a next step, what we want to do is now physically move that data into my HANA database. So therefore, we go to the editor over here. It was open over here. And in this editor, we can now create an object called a replication task, an HDB rep task, where here I have an example of a rep task using that same Abbott adapter that we used for the virtual table. And basically, it will replicate two tables, that's KNL1 table and also another table. But here you can add as many objects as you want using that Add Object button, and again, navigating or searching for all the tables you want to replicate. You can add all the tables here in the replication task, and then when you execute this replication task, the data from those tables will be loaded from on-premise systems into your HANA database in the cloud. I can also see that if I go back here, because I executed this task previously, over here you will see, first of all, the virtual tables, ABAP tables, KNL1 and LFA1. But more important here, a real HANA table with the same name, so tables KNA1. But this, as you can see from the icon in front, is not a virtual table anymore, it's a real table, so the data is now stored in HANA. And if I run the query over here, it will now show the data here from this table physically residing in my HANA database. Good, here I did just an initial load, so at a certain point in time, copy over all my customer data. But we'll also provide real time. So back to my editor over here, I already prepared this, in this case, for a SQL Server database, where in my SQL Server database, I have a table categories. And this categories table, as you can see here in the replication behavior, is not only initial loaded, but also real time is enabled. So what happened when I execute this is, first of all, again, an initial load will happen. All the categories will be loaded from SQL Server into HANA. But right after the initial load is finished, we will also do the real-time replication, monitoring the database logs, and whenever there's a change in SQL Server, it will get replicated into my HANA database in the cloud. Good. We can also show that. So if I go here to the catalog, this is a table we're talking about. And again, I use the real table, not the virtual table. If you look at the contents, we see there are 8 categories with the names you see over here. So this is a result of my initial loads. If I now go to my SQL Server database, and that happens to be running here on the same machine as where my on-premise agent was. So if I here create a new category for demo, I commit here over here, and no matter how quick I switch screens now and do a refresh, the record will already be there. So you see there are 9 records there, and the new for demo category is over here. So this shows a real-time replication from, in this case, an on-premise SQL Server database to my HANA in the cloud. And finally, if you want to do more complex things, so we can go back to the editor. In the editor, we can also create an object called a flow graph. So you see a flow graph over here. If I enlarge it a little bit, we're still reading from that KNA1 table, but instead of just replicating the data one-to-one, we do a transformation over here, a simple case transform, where based on a certain condition, in this example, the value of the country column, we'll move a record or remove a customer either to the US customer table, the Germany customer table, or all others here to a third table. Good, so if you would save and execute this, I saved it first, go here, and those are the 3 tables that will get created or that are already created. So here are my US customers. If I look at the contents, there is currently no data because this one I didn't execute yet. If I go to my editor and click execute now, so our agent will now read the data from that KNA1 table, run it through the flow graph and distribute it over the 3 tables. So if I go back over here and just do a refresh, you will see this table only contains US customers. There was another table here where I would see all my Germany customers and a third table with all other countries. Good. So this contain this concludes my quick demo on using Smart Data integration for HCP.